Risk due to climate change. Climate vulnerability and risk management is a part of dialogue and work with developing countries. Key sectors affected by climate change include health, water supply and sanitation, energy, transport, industry, mining, construction, trade, tourism, agriculture, forestry, fisheries, environmental protection, and disaster management as detailed ahead. Change in world climate would influence the functioning of many ecosystems and their member species. Likewise, there would be impacts on human health. Some of these health impacts would be beneficial. For example, milder winters would reduce the seasonal wintertime peak in deaths that occurs in temperate countries, while in currently hot regions a further increase in temperatures might reduce the viability of disease-transmitting mosquito populations. Overall, however, scientists consider that most of the health impacts of climate change would be adverse. Climatic changes over recent decades have probably already affected some health outcomes. Indeed, the World Health Organization estimated, in its World Health Report 2002, that climate change was estimated to be responsible in 2000 for approximately 2.4% of worldwide diarrhea, and 6% of malaria in some middle-income countries. However, small changes, against a noisy background of ongoing changes in other causal factors, are hard to identify. Once spotted, causal attribution is strengthened, if there are similar observations in different population settings. The first detectable changes in human health may well be alterations in the geographic range, latitude and altitude, and seasonality of certain infectious diseases, including vector-borne infections such as malaria and dengue fever, and food-borne infections, for example salmonellosis, which peak in the warmer months. Warmer average temperatures combined with increased climatic variability would alter the pattern of exposure to thermal extremes and resultant health impacts, in both summer and winter. By contrast, the public health consequences of the disturbance of natural and managed food-producing ecosystems, rising sea levels and population displacement for reasons of physical hazard, land loss, economic disruption and civil strife, may not become evident for up to several decades. Science Daily, March 11, 2012. The Greenland ice sheet is likely to be more vulnerable to global warming than previously thought. The temperature threshold for melting the ice sheet completely is in the range of 0.8 to 3.2 degrees Celsius of global warming, with a best estimate of 1.6 degrees above pre-industrial levels, shows a new study by scientists from the Potsdam Institute for Climate Impact Research, PIK, and the Universidad Complutense de Madrid. Today, already 0.8 degrees of global warming has been observed. Substantial melting of land ice could contribute to long-term sea level rise of several meters, and therefore it potentially affects the lives of many millions of people. The time it takes before most of the ice in Greenland is lost strongly depends on the level of warming. The more we exceed the threshold, the faster it melts, says Alexander Robinson, lead author of the study now published in Nature Climate Change. In a business-as-usual scenario of greenhouse gas emissions, in the long run humanity might be aiming at 8 degrees Celsius of global warming. This would result in one-fifth of the ice sheet melting within 500 years and a complete loss in 2,000 years, according to the study. This is not what one would call a rapid collapse, says Robinson. However, compared to what has happened in our planet's history, it is fast. And we might already be approaching the critical threshold. In contrast, if global warming would be limited to 2 degrees Celsius, complete melting would happen on a timescale of 50.000 years. Still, even within this temperature range often considered a global guardrail, the Greenland ice sheet is not secure. Previous research suggested a threshold in global temperature increase for melting the Greenland ice sheet of a best estimate of 3.1 degrees, with a range of 1.9 to 5.1 degrees. The new study's best estimate indicates about half as much. Our study shows that under certain conditions the melting of the Greenland ice sheet becomes irreversible. This supports the notion that the ice sheet is a tipping element in the Earth system, says team leader Andrei Ganapolsky of PIK. If the global temperature significantly overshoots the threshold for a long time, the ice will continue melting and not regrow, even if the climate would, after many thousand years, return to its pre-industrial state. This is related to feedbacks between the climate and the ice sheet. The ice sheet is over 3,000 meters thick and thus elevated into cooler altitudes as shown in Figure 2a. When it melts, its surface comes down to lower altitudes with higher temperatures, which accelerates the melting. Also, the ice reflects a large part of solar radiation back into space. When the area covered by ice decreases, more radiation is absorbed and this adds to regional warming. A. The Greenland ice sheet is likely to be more vulnerable to global warming than previously thought. The temperature threshold for melting the ice sheet completely is in the range of 0.8 to 3.2 degrees Celsius of global warming, with a best estimate of 1.6 degrees above pre-industrial levels, shows a new study. Today, already 0.8 degrees global warming has been observed. Credit, copyright Martin Schwann, Fotolia. B. This visualization, based on new computer modeling, shows that sea level rise may be an additional 10 centimeters, 4 inches, higher by populated areas in northeastern North America than previously thought. Extreme northeastern North America and Greenland may experience even higher sea level rise. Credit, graphic courtesy Geophysical Research Letters, modified by UCAR. The scientists achieved insights by using a novel computer simulation of the Greenland ice sheet and the regional climate. This model performs calculations of these physical systems, including the most important processes, for instance climate feedbacks associated with changes in snowfall and melt under global warming. The simulation proved able to correctly calculate both the observed ice sheet of today and its evolution over previous glacial cycles, thus increasing the confidence that it can properly assess the future. All this makes the new estimate of Greenland temperature threshold more reliable than previous ones, as shown in Figure 2b. Sea ice in the Arctic has shrunk to its smallest extent ever recorded, smashing the previous record minimum and prompting warnings of accelerated climate change. Satellite images show that the rapid summer melt has reduced the area of frozen sea to less than 3.5 million square kilometers this week from August 27, 2012, less than half the area typically occupied 4 decades ago. Arctic sea ice cover has been shrinking since the 1970s, when it averaged around 8 meters square kilometer a year, but such a dramatic collapse in ice cover in 1 year is highly unusual. A record low in 2007 of 4.17 million square kilometer was broken on Monday, August 27, 2012. Further melting has since amounted to more than 500,000 square kilometers. The record, which is based on a 5-day average, is expected to be officially declared in the next few days by the National Snow and Ice Data Center, NSIC, in Colorado. The NSIC's data shows the sea ice extent is bumping along the bottom, with a new low of 3.421 meters square kilometer on Tuesday, which rose very slightly to 3.429 meters square kilometer on Wednesday and 3.45 meters square kilometer on Thursday, as seen in Figure 3. The shrinking of the ice cap was interpreted by environment groups as a signal of long-term global warming caused by man-made greenhouse gas emissions. A study published in July in the journal Environmental Research Letters, that compared model projections with observations, estimated that the radical decline in Arctic sea ice has been between 70 to 95% due to human activities. Scientists have predicted on 31st of August 2012 that the Arctic Ocean could be ice-free in summer months within 20 years, leading to possibly major climate impacts. I am surprised. This is an indication that the Arctic sea ice cover is fundamentally changing. The trends all show less ice and thinner ice, said Julian Strova, a research scientist with NSIC. We are on the edge of one of the most significant moments in environmental history as sea ice heads towards a new record low. The loss of sea ice will be devastating, raising global temperatures that will impact on our ability to grow food and causing extreme weather around the world, said John Sauvin, director of Greenpeace UK. Sea ice experts said that they were surprised by the collapse because weather conditions were not conducive to a major melt this year. The ice is now believed to be much thinner than it used to be and easier to melt. Arctic sea ice follows an annual cycle of melting through the warm summer months and refreezing in the winter. The sea ice plays a critical role in regulating climate, acting as a giant mirror that reflects much of the sun's energy, helping to cool the Earth. David Nussbaum, chief executive of WWF UK, said, "The disappearance of Arctic ice is the most visible warning sign of the need to tackle climate change and ensure we have a world fit to pass on to the next generation. The sheer scale of ice loss is shocking and unprecedented. This alarm call from the Arctic needs to reverberate across Whitehall and boardrooms."